Hello, welcome to Herald of Mary HOM channel. Glory to Jesus, honor to Mary and Joseph. 10 things that Pope Francis wants us to learn from the Nativity scene. Before we proceed, let us sing Christmas song. Felix Navidad, tan tan tara. Felix Navidad, tan tan tara. Felix Navidad, prospera noia felicidad. Tan tara. Felix Navidad, tan tan tara. Felix Navidad, tan tan tara. Felix Navidad, prospera noia felicidad. Oh, I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wish all my subscribers, returning subscribers, new subscribers, everybody a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. Thank you so very much to all my subscribers, returning subscribers, and new subscribers. Thank you so very much. You have all have been amazing. Thank you so very much. Now, without wasting much of our time, let us dive into the topic of the day. 10 things that Pope Francis wants us to learn from the Nativity scene. 1 is the Nativity scene is like a living gospel. The depiction of Jesus' birth is a simple and joyful proclamation of the mystery of the incarnation of the Son of God, Pope writes. The Nativity scene invites everyone who contemplates it on a spiritual journey, drawing by the humility of God, who became man in order to encounter every man and woman. 2, the custom is rooted in the Bible. The Pope underlines that the Nativity scene rises from the pages of sacred, says that Mary gave birth to her first son born, manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Luke 2 verse 7. The manger is the focus of Nativity scenes. Italian word for Nativity scene is presepe, from the Latin word precepium, meaning manger. 3, the Nativity scene, the tradition was born in an unassuming Italian town. St. Francis of Assisi stopped in Greccio in November 1223, probably on his way back from Rome after receiving papal approval for the rule of his religious order. 15 days to life, the memory of that babe born in Bethlehem. To see as much as possible with my own bodily eyes the discomfort of his infant needs. How he lay in a manger, and how with an ox and an ass standing by, he was laid upon a bed of hay. Then on Christmas Day, St. Francis was joined by his friars and people from the surrounding area before a manger full of hay washed over an ox and a donkey. 4, the first Nativity scene was connected to the Eucharist. Describing the scene in Greccio that day, Pope Francis writes, all those present experienced a new and indescribable joy in the presence of the Christmas scene. The priest then solemnly celebrated the Eucharist over the manger, showing the born and the Eucharist. Unlike in Nativity scene today, the Pope says there were no statues. Instead, the Nativity scene was enacted and expressed. The original Nativity vision, The Pope recalls that one of the witnesses to the first Nativity scene saw a mass vision. Thomas of Celeno, the first biographer of St. Francis, wrote that one of those present saw the baby Jesus himself lying in the manger. Please, as you listen, kindly subscribe to my channel. Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. Let's proceed. 6. The Nativity scene is a means of evangelization. The Pope says that by creating the Nativity scene, St. Francis carried out a great work of evangelization that continues to touch hearts to this day. A simple yet authentic means of portraying the beauty of our faith that was accessible to all. 7. The manger is a sign of God's love. Pope Francis writes that Nativity scenes resonate so deeply because they show God's tender love. They proclaim that the Creator of the universe lowered himself to take up our littleness. They engage the senses and imagination, helping people to feel and touch the poverty that God's Son took upon himself in the incarnation. 8. The Nativity scene contains a call to service. The Pope says that the Christmas script contains an implicit message. It summons us to follow him along the path of humility, poverty, and self-denial that leads from the manger of Bethlehem to the cross, he writes. It asks us to meet him and serve him by showing mercy to those of our brothers and sisters in greatest need. 9. Even in Nativity scenes, landscapes are meaningful. The Pope notes that depictions of the Nativity often include the ruins of ancient houses or buildings. He writes, "More than anything, the ruins are the visible sign of fallen humanity, of everything that inevitably falls into ruin, decays, and disappoints." These scenic settings tells us that Jesus is newness in the midst of an aging world, that he has come to heal and rebuild, to restore the world and our lives to their original splendor. 10. Nativity scene nourished devotion to Mary and Joseph. The Pope observed that the Virgin Mary known as a mother who contemplates her child and shows him to every visitor. In her, we see the mother of God who does not keep her son only to herself, but invites everyone to obey his word and to put it into practice. Saint Joseph stands at Mary's side, protecting her and the Christ child. The Nativity scene reminds us that Joseph entrusted himself always to God's will and put it into practice. He encourages us to do the same. These are the 10 things that Pope Francis wants us to learn from the Nativity scene. We really thank God for bringing us to the end, almost to the end of 2021. Despite all that we saw, God still kept us alive till this Christmas day. No matter the coronavirus and this new one coming that is called Omicron, God still kept us alive. All the lockdown for us down here in Nigeria, everything we saw, God still kept us alive. And we say to him, may be all the glory, all the honor, adoration, dominion, excellency, authority be ascribed unto the name of the Lord, both now and forever. Amen. Thank you so very much for listening, and we thank you, Lord, for keeping us alive.
And we pray and we hope that 2022 is going to be a greater year for us. Unto good and unto good. And we know that 2022, we are going to achieve exploits. And we are going to live also to see the end of 2022. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being there. Thank you for the massive love. I thank God for all of us. I thank God for this year, Christmas. Have a reason to rejoice no matter what you're going through. Because it is not easy for one to be alive. And because we are alive, we need to thank God. Because once there is life, there is hope. Once there is life, there is hope. We will surely see a light at the end of the tunnel, no matter what. Our Lady said that at the end, her immaculate heart will triumph. Run to God, He is our self-refuge. And do not despair. I repeat, do not despair. Do not lose hope. Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.